They told they are having an
what is the file number? 5. One person can have multiple mail accounts. Mail accounts information let us store in another table. Primary information of a person storing in the person table. All the mail accounts information of a particular person. For one person, n number of mail accounts. Every mail account information let us store in another table. Copy both create SQL commands. If you are dropping a person with the cascade constraints, even though person having a child tables, person table will be removing, child tables foreign key constraint will be removing. Got it? Even though person table having some child tables, forcibly removing person table without removing child tables. That can be done through cascade constraints. Through cascade constraints. Person table will be dropping, child tables will be as it is, only child tables foreign key constraint will be removing. Child tables, whatever foreign key constraint is there, that foreign key constraint only will remove. child tables will be available with the child tables data. Cascade constraints. Try to run person. If at all mail account is there, drop it. No mail account, then create a mail account. Mail account having a foreign key. That foreign key referring to person table ID column. Person table ID column already qualified as a primary key. Come on. Inside a mail account table, person underscore ID is a foreign key. That is referring to person table. Person table ID column. Person table ID column. So what is the difference between the yesterday's two tables and today's two tables? Yesterday we have created person and address. Inside the address table, person underscore ID, it was a foreign key. Same foreign key was qualified as a unique also. Have you remembered or not? Foreign key we made as a unique additionally. So, if foreign key is a unique or primary, you will be getting one-to-one mapping. If foreign key is a unique or primary, then you will be getting one-to-one mapping. Now here, foreign key is not a unique, not a primary. In the mail account table, person underscore ID is a foreign key. Person underscore ID is a foreign key. Person underscore ID is a foreign key. That foreign key is not a unique, not a primary. Not a unique, not a primary. So foreign key allows duplicates. If foreign key is allowing duplicates, then one person can have a multiple mail accounts. Person Vijay, assume ID 1. That ID 1 can be duplicated in the mail account table under person underscore ID. SR2. Same person can have n number of mail accounts. This is called as a one-to-many. One person record mapping to multiple records of mail account. Multiple records of mail account. One person record mapping to multiple records of mail account. And one more thing here. One person record mapping to multiple records of mail account. Very important one more point is one mail account record not belonging to multiple persons? One mail account will not be belonging to multiple persons. It's the argument. Multiple mail accounts will belong to one person. Yes, sir. Person to mail account is one to money. Mail account to person is money to one. Wherever one to money is there money to one we can use. Yes, sir. Money mail accounts referring to one person. Person to mail account is one to money. Mail account to person is money to one. Many mail accounts referring to one person. Money mail accounts referring to one person. One to many, many to one. Now try to insert the data. Totally 5 persons. One, two, three, four, five. Totally 5 persons. For person 1, 3 mail accounts, 2 mail accounts in the Gmail, 1 mail account in the Hotmail. Is it possible or not? How many mail accounts you have in the Gmail? Definitely more than one. Yes, sir. Same person can have any number of mail accounts. Person 2, 2 mail accounts. Person 3, 1 mail account. Person 4, 1 mail account. The last mail account not belonging to any person. Possible? We are trying to insert null value under foreign key. By default, null value alone under the foreign key. By default, duplicates also allowing in the foreign key. To avoid null value, foreign key should have additionally not null. Now in our child table, foreign key doesn't have additionally not null. It is taking a null value. Let us read all person records. Totally 5 records are there. Totally 5 records under person. So totally 8 mail accounts are there. User 1 XYZ Gmail. It is not belonging to any person yet. You can assign this mail account to any of the available person afterwards. You can update the last record by specifying person underscore ID as one of the ID in the person table. Any ID you can, whichever is available. Remember, Murali doesn't have mail accounts so far. No mail accounts to Murali. And the last mail account, user1xyz in the Gmail, is not allocated to any person yet. We can allocate to any of the available person later through update command. Yes or no? I am reading every information about Ramu, whichever is available in the person table. In the person table, whatever data available, that data we are reading for the Ramu. In the mail account table, I am reading a record whichever having username as Ramu1. Username as Ramu1. I'm reading all the mail accounts of a person whose ID is 3. Come on. Whose ID is 3? Here only one mail account. Only one mail account. Assume you know name of the person, you need to find out all mail accounts information of the same person. This type of subqueries already we have seen several. Supply name to the person table, supply name to the person table, get corresponding ID, send that ID to the mail account, get all the records whichever having same ID. Ramu having email accounts. Ramu person ID is a 1. 1 we are supplying to the mail account table. 1 we are supplying to the mail account table. Assume you know username of a mail account. Through username of the mail account, you should know person information. Supply the username to the mail account table. Find out what is the person ID. Supply that person ID to the person table. Subquery. Got it? Now let's go for joins. Whatever joins we have seen yesterday, same joins. Inner join, three outer joins. First one is through where condition. Joining two tables with the where condition, always it will be inner join. While joining two tables through where condition, it will be an inner join. You know what is an inner join? Interception. You know what is an inner join? Interception. You can use aliasing names In case of Inner Jai, Murali will not be coming. Why? Because he doesn't have any mail accounts yet. The last mail account, it is not belonging to any person yet. Explicitly specify join name. While specifying join name, you should not use where condition. You have to use on. Based on which condition you are joining. Left out, left side table is a person table. From a person table, even Murali also has to get. Even Murali also. Right outer join. Right side joining table is a mail account table. From the mail account table, last mail account also reading because of right out. If it is full out, so here. First mail account is coming, then Murali is coming. If you wanted first Murali, then mail account, you can go for order by. So order can be fixed only through order by. Got it. Understood, one to many, many to one. What is the condition to be followed for achieving one to many or many to one? Parenti. Come again, little loud. Parenti should have a unicorn primary. Parenti should not have a unicorn primary to achieve one to many. Should not have. By chance, if parenti is a unicorn primary, then you cannot achieve one to many, it will go for one to one. Yes or no? If it is one to one, foreign key should be unique or should be primary. If it is one to many, foreign key should not be unique, should not be primary. If foreign key is a unique, you won't have a duplicates. You cannot achieve one to many. So that money means any number, 0, 1, 2, 3. Here Murali 0, Sweta only 1, Ramu 3, 1 to many, the child table, any number of records, it can be 0 or 1 or 2 or any. Last one. Money to money. Please observe, guys. In general, one student might have multiple skills or not. It can be zero number of skills. Some students might have only one skill. Some students might have two skills. Some students might have 10 skills. There is a chance. One student can have n number of skills. That n number can be zero number also. One student can have zero skills. One student can have only one skill. One student can have two skills. Not only programming skills. Consider any skill. Any skill. Student can have 0, 1, 2, 3, any number. Let us consider a particular skill. That will be known to the multiple students or not? Same skill will be known to multiple students. in the previous tables, one person can have any number of mail accounts. One mail account belonging to one person only. One mail account not belonging to multiple persons. Come to here. One student having multiple skills. One skill is knowing to multiple students. Yes, sir. In both the directions, you can find one to many. One student having multiple skills. One skill having to the multiple students. In both the directions, if it is one to many, then it comes under many to many. This is treated as a many to many. One student having multiple skills. Same skill knowing to the multiple students. Same skill. One skill itself knowing to the multiple students. One to many in both the directions. So, it will be treated as a many to many. So here, guys, one student having multiple skills. One skill knowing to the multiple students. How we can maintain this mapping? One student record should map to multiple skill records. One skill record, how we can map to multiple student records? Difficulty are you finding or not? One student can map to multiple skill records. One skill should map to multiple student records. In the previous mapping, person and mail accounts. One person can have a mapping of multiple mail accounts. We are not taking care of mail account mapping in the person table. Yes, sir. Now what we have to do? Skills also we have to take care in the person table, in the student table here. Yes, sir. So that cannot be possible with the two tables. We required a third table to achieve money to money. That you can call like an intermediate table. That table is only for the mapping purpose. Yeah. even though Cheyli tables are there to the student that can be dropped successfully through cascade is going to construct. Let us create a student table. Observe student table doesn't have any skill related columns. Student table doesn't have any skill related columns. But student table ID is a unique. At any moment you can make student as a parent by defining a child table. When one table can be parent? When it can become a parent? To become a table as a parent, the condition should be that should have a minimum one unique key or at least a private. Then only it can qualify as a parent in down the line. SR. You can make student as a parent at any time, but as of now, student doesn't have any columns related to skill. SR. No. Come to the next one. If at all skill table is there, remove that skill table. Create a skill table. Skill table also having ID as a unit. You can make a skill as a parent at any time. You can create a child tables to the student table. One more point. Skill table doesn't have any student related columns. Come on. Skill table doesn't have any skill, sorry, any column. Related to student, any column related to student. Now both the tables are independent or not? Come on. Skill is not depending on student, student is not depending on skill. Both are independent tables. So now both the tables, it doesn't have any kind of relation. Come on. Now both the tables, it doesn't have any kind of relation. Both are independent. Let us insert four students. Four students. While inserting student, we are not at all bothering about what are the skills. No column in the student table which is related to skill. Yes or no? We are inserting four skills. No skill having a student information. Yes or no? Both the tables are independent as of now. To make the relation between these two tables many to many, we required one intermediate table. I am choosing student underscore skill as a intermediate table. If it is available, drop it. Check it out. Student underscore skill table. Student underscore skill. student underscore skill. So how many columns are there under student underscore skill? Only two columns. Both the columns are foreign keys. One is referring to student table, other is referring to skill table. This is a child to two parents. These are the child to two parents. Child to two parents. Student table ID column unique. Same is referring by student underscore skill table inside that student underscore ID. Skill underscore ID, it is a foreign key to ID column of the skill table. Check it out. It's only for providing a mapping between two tables. It is not having any other information. It doesn't have skill name or student name, skill description or student age or something. It is only having student ID, skill ID. Two columns only. It is only for providing a mapping. So four mappings. Sorry, five mappings. So what is the meaning of this? Anybody? Five inserts are there. What could be the meaning of these five inserts? Yeah. Based on the records, what you can understand? Student ID 1, mapping to two skills, skill ID 1 and skill ID 2. Student ID 2, mapping to only one skill, that is skill ID 2. Student ID 3, mapping to skill ID 1 and skill ID 4. Yes or no? Now you can see, one student mapping to multiple skills or not. One skill mapping to multiple students or not? One student mapping to multiple skills. One skill mapping to multiple students. Skill ID 2 mapping to 2 students. Skill ID 1 mapping to 2 students. Skill ID 4 mapping to 1 student. Skill ID 5 not mapping. Yes or no? I think 5 is not there. Skill ID 3 not mapping. Skill ID 3 is not mapped. Student ID 4 no skills. Come on up. Student ID 4 no skills. Skill ID 3 no students. Money to money we can achieve only through intermediate table. student ID 1 mapping to skill ID 1 and 2. Student ID 3 mapping to skill ID 1 and 4. Student ID 2 mapping to skill ID 2. Now check it out. Reading all three separately. Four students are there. Student number 4, Kumar. Student number 3, Murali. Student number 4, Kumar. Student number 3, Murali. What about skill? Four skills are there. Every skill having a unique ID. No one is knowing Java. Yes or no? Java skill ID is 3. Java skill ID is 3. They have to learn Java. Who is not knowing even a single skill? Who is that for? Kumar. So Kumar doesn't have anything related to student. Thank you. student Kumar doesn't have any skill mappings. Java skill not going to any student. Isardo. Skill ID 3, no one knows. Student ID 4 doesn't have any skills. Now, how to find out are the skills of a Vijay? I know name of the student. By using name of the student, how we can get all the skill names? Student name is there in the student table. Skill names are there in the skill table. By supplying an input as a student name, you have to need all the skill names. Supply the student name, get the student ID. Supply that student ID to the intermediate table. Get all the skill IDs for a particular student ID. Then supply that all skill IDs to the skill table and read the names of the skills. Got it? Student name you know. Supply that name to the student table. Get the student ID. Supply that student ID to the intermediate table. For that student ID, whatever skill IDs are there, read all the skill IDs. Supply all the skill IDs to the skill table to get names of the skills. Yes, sir. First, I am finding out what is the ID of the student. Vijay student. Vijay student. No student. Huh? No Vijay. Which student is available? Ramu, Rama. Let's go for Ram. Ramu student ID. Ramu student ID. It is a 1. So 1 is supplying as a value to the innermost query. That 1 we are supplying to the intermediate table to read the skill IDs. You are getting skill IDs are 1 and 2. Supply that 1 and 2. Already we know in. You know in or not? No idea. What is in? Specified records it will be reading. Yes or no? Now, select a name from skill where ID in 1 comma 2. Mom. Yes or no? I repeat one more time, please observe. First running innermost query. What is the innermost query here? Selecting ID from the student where first name is Ram. Got it? That one is supplying to the inner query. This is the one. For that 1, 2 skill IDs are coming, 1 and 2, supply 1 comma 2, This query looks like this. Yes, sir, no guys. If you want to read only one record, then go for ID is equal to. If you want to read multiple records, then you have to go for ID in the bracket you have to specify one by one, one by one. In the first day itself, I told in. Yes, sir. You can go through SQL 1 or SQL 2. You will be finding in. You want to know student names, who knows to see? Who knows to see? What is the procedure? For the C skill, what is the ID? Read that ID. Supply that ID to the intermediate table. For that ID, whatever student IDs are mapped, read all the student IDs. Supply that student IDs to the student table to read the names. Sir, no. It's one and the same of previous, but it is in the opposite direction. First, you find out what is the ID for the C skill. For the C skill, ID is the one. Then find out which students knowing C skills. Mapping in the intermediate table. We are getting student IDs 1 and 3. Specify 1 comma 3. Run the entire command.
Thank you.
Got it? Now let's see join. Very important. Guys, student data is there in the student table, skill data is there in the skill table. I need to join both. Student is first name, is skill ID, skill name, all I had to get in the same row. Student name, skill name, I had to see in the same row. Student name is there in the student table, skill name is there in the skill table. There is no direct mapping between student and skill for mapping purpose or intermediate table. Now what we have to do is, student should join with the intermediate table. Student is joining with the intermediate table, getting the results. That results should join with the skill table. Totally two joins required. Student table joining with the intermediate table, getting the results. Treat that results as a one temporary table. That temporary table should join with the skill table. Totally two joins. In these two joins, you can independently choose the type. First join inner, second one can be inner or left outer or right outer or full outer. First one is a left outer, second one can be inner or left outer, right outer, full outer. It's purely based on which type of data you have to read. Got it? First join, joining with student and intermediate table. After joining student with intermediate table, you are getting a data. That data you are joining with the skill table. What kind of records you wanted? Based on that, you can choose independently whatever join you wanted. If first join is a inner, second join doesn't require to be inner only. It's purely based on your requirement, which data you have to read. If first join is a left outer, second join doesn't require to be left outer only. It's purely based on. See, you can treat like independent. First we are joining, we are getting one table. That table is joining with the third table. That is second join. Both the joins are independent. In the same query, two joins are there. First join results joining with the third table. First join is joining between student and intermediate, getting the results. Treat that results as one temporary table. That table is joining with the third table to a second join. First join and second join, both are independent. Purely based on your requirement, you can use any join. It's purely based on data. Are you finding two joins in the select command? Select star from student comma, student underscore skill comma and skill. Where we are using where condition here. Specify first two tables common content like a common values of a columns. First two tables, whatever common values are there. First table is a student table, ID column. Second table is the intermediate table, student underscore ID count. So, then the second join. In the results, skill underscore ID is there or not? In the results, skill underscore ID is there. That skill underscore ID, you are comparing with skill table ID cover. Skill table ID cover. Two where conditions. First where condition joining with the first two tables. Results joining with the third table. For first two tables, take the columns which are having common values. Student table ID, intermediate table, student underscore ID having the common values. You can come back. Getting a resultant table, temporary table. In that temporary table, skill underscore ID is there or not? Come on, skill underscore ID is there. That you have to compare with ID column of the skill table. By default, both will be inner join. Both the joins will be inner join. By default, both the joins are inner join. See, Kumar student not available. Kumar student not available. Is Argo? Kumar student not available. Java skill also not available. Java skill also not available. Same, you can specify join names. Here you can understand clearly the last command. First one. This is one join. I ran only one join. I ran only one join. Just to observe the selected portion. It is first join. You are getting a results. That results are joining with another table. Come on. These are the results with the first join. From the first join, these are the results. That results are joining with the skill table. Come on. Again inner join. Start down. Inner join with a skill. Skill. SK as a aliasing name, condition. Both we are keeping inner join explicitly, interception data. SR. This is very, very important, guys. First join results joining with the third table. First join results joining with the third table. First join is joining between first two tables, getting the results. Treat that results as a one table, temporary table. That table is joining with the third table through a second join. To join three tables, you require two joins. To join four tables, you require three joins. To join 10 tables, you require 9 joins. Got it up. On condition. Here I mentioned only both in the. Now you can experiment independently. First one inner, second one left outer. First one inner, second one right outer. First one inner, second one full outer. First one left outer, second one inner, second one left outer, second one right outer, full out. All combinations try to experiment, get the understanding. Understood? Very simple, no? Simple or difficult? If you find difficulty, no problem. Run all the commands once again. Right from SQL 1 onwards, SQL 1.5. All these commands run again and again, try to understand everything.